You see the light?
Okay.
Awesome. All right, guys. We'll take it away, and good luck.
What is honesty? Is it not lying? As James E. Fox, the famous politician, once said, it's not only not lying, it's truth-telling, it's truth-speaking, truth-living, and truth-loving. Honesty is being strong and truthful. Honesty is hard, even I have to say, but it is worth it, even if lying has been incorporated into our daily lives. Honesty helps you, and not only you, but your friends. And they know that their friend is honest and truthful, and that really makes a great friend. Honesty will help you throughout much life much more than a lie could. First of all, being honest will help your character in relationships, whereas lies will beat them down and break them down and beat them to the ground. Think about a sports team, for a team sport, such as soccer. There always seems like there's one guy who always thinks he's the best and over-exaggerates everything to make himself look good. He lies to make himself look better, but in reality, it makes him look worse. People know he's lying and just don't want to be around him because of it. Even throughout history, lying hurt people's relationships. One example was at the Treaty of Versailles, where Italy was lied to with a broken promise of land and enraged because of it. This ruined their relationship with the Allies and made the Allies look bad to the people of Italy. Lies can truly break down a relationship and a person's character. Secondly, a lie can go way too far. It can start as a small little joke and then grow until it cannot be stopped. For one example is an animal farm. The pigs took power after the rebellion. They started with small little lies, like how they needed the apples and the milk for their brains. But then they started to grow. The lies started to grow. They felt like they needed more. They started changing the commandments to their likings and getting more stuff, like just beds and beer. Eventually it got to the peak where the pigs lied so much that they got down to their original low without the animals even turning a head. Rumors can also grow and spread very fast. Someone could spread a false rumor about someone else and it'll spread like wildfire. And once it gets out of hand and someone figures it out, that person who started the rumor will be known for that and usually not trusted. Lies are dangerous and can spread rapidly and get out of hand quick. Whether or not it is difficult, honesty is truly the best policy. It will get you much further than lies can. Honesty will bring you up, make you look good, and put you at much less of a risk of being infamous. Lies will bring you down, ruin your friendships, and beat down your character, and really make you known for awful things when you really aren't that bad of a person. Many people may lie. In fact, 60% of people lie in a 10-minute conversation, which shows honesty may be more difficult sometimes, but no matter what, it's always worth it to be honest. Thank you, and now stand ready for cross-examination.
You agree that Santa Claus is not real, but a childhood fantasy that brings joy to children, correct?
Yes.
Well, would you tell a 3-year-old that Santa Claus isn't real?
No.
So therefore you would be lying to them for their own sake?
Yes.
Would you lie to save someone's life?
Depends on the situation. Could you give an example?
Let's say if you had to lie and you had, if let's say your mom was hostage and the people who took her hostage said not to call the police. And if they asked you if you called the police and you actually did, would you tell them yes?
No.
Okay, move on. People house slaves and save them from extreme labor, those against the law. Do you think that this type of dishonesty was negative?
Could you rephrase that?
During the Atlantic slave trade, there were times when people housed slaves and even those against the law and lied about it. Do you think that was negative?
Yes, I do.
How?
Well, if they housed slaves, then slavery was wrong, and that's why we moved on from it. And if it was wrong to have any slavery, and since they were lying about it,
well, I
wrong.
Meant housing escaped slaves. That
oh,
were
escaped slaves.
Yes.
Oh. Well, if if it was against the law, then...
Time. All right. There will be your opening argument.
We've learned from a young age that dishonesty is bad. But in everyday life, people often find themselves lying for a good cause. That's the reason why I do not support the statement, honesty is the best policy. In a research study conducted by the University of Massachusetts, 60% of adults can't go through a 10-minute conversation without lying. In fact, people lie an average of 3 times during their conversation. Clearly, if people lie this much, lying is incredibly common and may be necessary to succeed in this world. In certain circumstances, you can save many lives and spare many feelings through dishonesty. During the Atlantic slave trade, a few courageous souls decided to hide escaped slaves in their houses. People lied about hiding them, even those against the law. This saved many mistreated slaves' lives. As you can see, lying with a good purpose can make a huge difference and touch other people's lives in a very good way. In daily life, lying about someone's appearance or ability in a positive way can boost their self-esteem and make them feel better. You might even make their day. Speaking your mind and your true opinions can easily cost you a friend. Little white lies like this can only make someone feel better. Individuals with altruistic intentions are perceived to be more moral, more benevolent, and more honest, even when they lie, said doctoral candidate Emma Levine. To clarify, that means that studies have shown that people who lie with good intentions are thought to be more moral and, in fact, more honest. Another example of where lying is necessary is when a little kid asks if Santa is real. Would you tell him no? That would ruin one of the wonders of childhood. This type of dishonesty affects people only in a positive way. If you think about it, a number of leaders have used dishonesty to become powerful. They've lied to create more cohesive and cooperative societies and to keep their countries more stable and united. One example of this is of the famous pharaohs who told the citizens of Egypt that they were gods. This strategy obviously worked well, as the pharaohs ruled for an era of peace lasting 3 centuries. Lying your way to the top through empty promises to your followers is also quite effective. In other words, one can say dishonesty is an acceptable form of behavior in human society because it's a common strategy in politics. In Animal Farm, Napoleon the Pig is a great example at this point. He lies continuously to eventually become a dictator. Lying or exaggeration is an effective tactic that many countries have demonstrated through the use of propaganda. During World War I and the Chinese Revolution, there was lots of propaganda that exaggerated messages. This led many people to believe certain things that were not true. However, these tactics allowed the government to recruit more people for the war and sometimes change the outcome of them in favor of the propaganda-using country. In conclusion, there are many situations where dishonesty may be necessary despite all our good intentions. Dishonesty may be necessary to save lives, to make people feel better, to capture power, and to maintain a stable, peaceful society and run strong countries. Thank you. I now stand ready for cross-examination.
Do you feel that it is right to tell someone that they are better than they are?
Yes.
Do you not feel that this would boost the ego sometimes too much?
In some cases, maybe, but normally I would only do it if they were feeling down on themselves.
How far do you feel you could really get with lies?
You can get pretty far, like Napoleon, he lied, and he became a dictator and got everything he wanted.
He did get everything he wanted, but did he have a positive, outcome on the animal farm?
Well, he had a positive outcome on himself, and that's what matters.
Well, I politely disagree with that it's not the only thing that matters, that the group also matters in that situation. They were the one that helped him get there, and he sort of basically ignored what they wanted and did what he wanted.
Well, honesty was the best. Honesty was not the best policy for him.
Do you feel that lies being stressed because of the, stress to keep it up?
Not necessarily.
Well, doesn't it seem... Do you not think it's if you're telling a lie, you feel stressed to keep up that lie.
No.
Well, say your friend... Okay, never mind.
All right. Glad you have 1 minute. Prepare your closing statements. We'll hear from Gwyn first.
We may lie a lot, but truth will always be the best. Truth keeps and gains friends, and honesty builds your character. Whereas lies will hurt you, not only you, but your friends too. Lies can tear down your character and go way too far. Lies can grip people's egos and create people that no one wants to be around. My opponent argued that white lies to boost people's egos have no downside, really. But I disagree with that, because white lies like that could really boost people's egos and create people, like I said, that no one wants to be around. All in all, though, honesty gets you much further than any lie could, and will help you much more than a lie. Honesty is truly the best policy, and as Thomas Jefferson once said, honesty is the first chapter in the Book of Wisdom. Thank you.
As we all know now, there are some cases where dishonesty would make a positive impact on people and the world. Oftentimes, it is necessary to use dishonesty to save lives, to protect people, to boost the self-esteem of those you care for, to encourage people to sacrifice for the greater good, and to preserve stable societies. My opponent argued that honesty is necessary to maintain relationships, but I disagree. Telling the truth sometimes can hurt someone's feelings dramatically and possibly end the relationship. In other words, sometimes you have to be dishonest to do the right thing. Thank you.
Great. Thank you, guys.